So here you can find there is another CAD model we're going to be, and with respect to this, we need to develop this model. Okay, so what input we have, we'll check that first. So input we're going to be having something like the class A surface, which is partially given. Okay, so here you can find, so class A surface is partially given in this particular area. Then again, we're going to be have class reference over there. Okay, so what are we going to be have? Master section is given as well as studio surface is given. Okay, so this is something like the two surfaces, two input we are given, and from that they are something like checking for our output. Okay, so output definitely going to be expected over here. It's to create the flange. So that is the follow the master section. That is the one thing. And another thing will be doing the closed volume. So having a tooling line, it means we need to, we need not to be find the tooling line, but definitely we need to check over here what tooling line, whatever the tooling line is given, with respect to that, we need to check the part. Okay, so here definitely we need to go for the draft analysis. So this is kind of the CAD test. You might be seen into the CAD interviews. So where there are the deviation into the flange, there might be the deviation into the length, deviation into the angle. Here you can check whatever the information is given is nothing but the class input surface and master section. What they're expecting, we need to do modify the class surface to match this particular master section. Then we can do the closed volume. Okay, so this is a requirement most of the time. Many of the OEM or the service-based company going to be have their CAD test similar to this to follow something, the instruction given over here, as well as we need to check some technical things, which is nothing but the draft analysis, as well as somewhere we're going to be at the undercut, extra additional feature we need to add, kind of thing will be there. Even the tooling feasibility, that is most important. If there is any slider, lifter going to be considered. So this information we need to consider, and with respect to that, here you can check kind of the CAD test will be given. Okay, so this is one of the CAD tests. Similar to that, we have the flange, and we will check. So what every CAD test going to be have one particular cracking point or the difficulty level. Okay, so each and every CAD test will not be thoroughly difficult. It having some moments, that moment will be difficult where you have to take the decisions. So decisions will be the tooling consideration, it might be the master section following, or somewhere here you can find the three sections are given and there is a merging we need to do in this particular area. As you can check over here, the what are the flange we have is 20 mm, here we have 15 mm, and in this area it might be the another value we have. Okay, so with respect to that, each and every CAD test going to be have some point where we need to take a decision. Okay, so here you can check. So in this particular area, what are we going to be have the change in flange length? Over here we have the 25. So the important thing, what we're going to be do in this particular corner. Okay, so that is the most important thing. So we will find somewhere here how we can do this particular crack, this particular CAD test, CAD model, with respect to we need to take a decision in this particular area. So depending upon this decision, we'll get selected or rejected. How you follow this particular area where there is no information is provided on this corner. Okay, so we'll go for that now. So you can check, we have the input, we have created the output folder. Into the output folder, we need to have this particular geometrical sets, class A, modification of class A, class B. Then you can check kind of this will be there. Then whatever we need to do the trim, so that also we need to add somewhere. Here you can check into the closed volume. We have the classes surface. In that, we're going to get join this particular surface. So we'll go for the distance propagation. We'll join this particular surface. Here you can check what are the surface we have so that we can join, and we'll have the color over here. Okay, so we can have a color for this particular part. Okay, and with respect to that, you can check. Some of the surfaces not get selected. Okay, some of the surfaces not get selected. You can double click and you can select that surfaces. Okay, so here you can find there is an error. Error is due to the merging distance. Okay, so we'll check over here. Reducing the merging distance, we can find reducing the merging distance will be work in this particular case. We'll see in next session how we're going to be without changing the merging distance, are we going to be join this particular part? So in that case, we need to modify the classes surface. Okay, we need to modify the classes surface. We'll check how we're going to be modify without changing the merging distance. In that case, you can find the boundary will be there throughout the periphery with respect to the merging distance what we have. So this is a class A we have. Now we need to do the class A modification. So you can name over here class A. Now we need to do the modification. For that, first of all, we have checked the length for this particular flange is varying. Okay. So in that case, if there is not vary this particular length, we will select the one only single boundary and have the sweep for the same value. Okay. But now you can find the variation in this particular CAD model will be not only the flange length, it might be again the value of this particular angle. Okay, so whatever we have the angles over here, okay, if you just check with the tooling line is given with respect to that, we're going to be have somewhere here the angle. So this angle is something like 90 degree, and even you can check for the other surfaces, it will be similar to that only. Okay, so it is 90. Okay, you can check the angle 90. Here also you can find the angle will be 90, but there might be the CAD test. You can find the angle will be more than 90. So how are you going to be solve this particular CAD test? Okay, if the angle is not the same, so we will check for that how it's going to be solved. Okay, so first of all, we need to create the boundary, and that boundary has to be three segments. Here you can check this will be the one, this will be the another, and this will be the third one. And with respect to that, we can create that particular area what we required. Okay, so we have selected the boundary. We need to have 20 mm here, 15 here. So what we can do, we will just make a segment with respect to controlling the point as we have earlier seen. So whatever the thing we're going to be make a parametric, we need to control with the points. You can select over here point, and with respect to the point, what we can do now here, you can check again, we will control this particular here as well. Okay, so first of all, we will just try to trim this. Okay, so before the trim, I will like to add here is also the point. You will just create the segments. Okay, so make sure whenever you will change this particular point, this point get travel over this point, there might be the error, you need to reselect again. So in that case, you need to reselect. Okay, so this is the only thing it will be happen. So now I will just try to trim this particular with the point. So this is now we will get one segment of the line. Okay, so this boundary we can sweep for 20 degree. Here we can create in between these two points, we'll create one boundary that will be saved for 15. And in this segment, we're going to be have for 25. And then we can check how we're going to be merge that particular corner. Okay. So this is kind of the thing we have. So what we are doing the practice, we are doing the practice for not only the change in a flange length, but also change in a angle of the flange. Okay. So that is our motive to make sure how it's going to be work. So I will just use the same sweep split. And with respect to that, I can just add the points, and this is how I'm going to be create that particular split without changing a new command. Okay, I will just replace, and quickly I can select the point, we'll get that particular three segments. Okay, so how effectively you're going to be use your CAD skill, that will be definitely save your time into the CAD interview. So here you can find we need to go with respect to this, we can go for with reference surface, you can select over here. We need to select the tooling line somewhere here. Okay, you can find the draft direction. You can select over here. You can select the tooling line. And in that case, if you just change the angle, I will just go for the 89 over here, because we need to check for right now in this area, we need to require the 90 itself. But if there is any angle change in another tooling tool test, so how are we going to be deal with that? So that also we're going to check over here. Okay. So a little bit angle we have changed with respect to that. You can find in this area also we need to go for the drop direction 90 degree, and here we need to keep the length over here is only 15, so we can directly have that 15, absolutely no issue. Then again the another corner we're going to be have the sweep, so that also we're going to be create from here. You can find the tooling direction something like this. We're going to be have again the angle, we can make it as 91. Okay, it should be less than 90, so 89.5 we can create. And now you can find we have this three segment. Now here with the length we need to maintain is 25. So you can maintain the 25. So now what we need to do, we need to create somewhere here flange. Okay, so we need to create the flange. How are we going to be create the flange? You can check something like this. We can select the boundary. With respect to boundary, again we need to split this boundary with respect to these two points. Okay, and in this area, whatever we have the area, the flange or the interface is not given. So here we need to take a decision. Okay, so what decision we need to take? We need to create a smooth surface in this area. Okay, so we need to create a smooth surface so that we can create with the multi-section. Okay, having this boundaries, this as a limit, we're going to be create this particular surface. Okay, this is a one and this is a two we're going to be create. Okay, so for that reason we required one another spline, so that we're going to be use create from over here, the command we have for the spline. So we can check from this to this, we can select one line to spline. Again from here to here we can select one another spline, and with respect to that you can check for preview, we'll get that particular preview. Okay, now you can find we can create something like this. Here you can extract the surfaces. Okay, we can check for multi-section from this to this, check for the preview. You can find somewhere here, you can select again, you can find, you can select, get this particular flange over there. Okay, so now you can check whatever we're going to be at the thing in this particular area. So now we need to change the point and we'll make sure it will be properly smooth transition will be there. Okay, so now here we can just play with the point, we can just move the point to make sure it will be smooth. Okay, so no rule is there, so it should be look like a smooth. So there will be little bit deviation we can observe from our naked eye. So that is only thing we need to make sure. Okay, it should look like a smooth right now. You can see what will be the worst condition. So this will be the worst condition. If we have the transition something like this, definitely this is a worst condition. Okay, you can find for your naked eyes also, this is not look like a pauper. Okay, so this will be something like, you can say it will be near about smooth we can create, because no information is given. As per our experience or as per our judgment, we need to create over here. Similar way in this direction, opposite side, we need to create another multi-section. Same thing we need to do. So we need to have this surface get split for this 2 point to get a reference for the multi-section. Again, you can find, we can select somewhere here boundary. Same thing over here, boundary. Then we need to create spline. So with respect to this point and the boundary tangent, again the point and the boundary as a tangent, we can select this particular okay, then you can just click okay. Then we definitely going to be here from here to here, check for the preview. Then you can check again for the boundary from this way, again from boundary for this way. Check for preview, and I can find similar way there is a deviation, and this deviation due to somewhere we need to control for the uniform. Okay, so same way we need to control this with the point. So definitely can check wherever we're going to put the point in this particular area, it will be going to be create the smooth one. Not only this point, you can also try with the another point to move somewhere here and get that smooth surface. So transition, whatever we're going to be have, that we need to control, and with respect to that, you can check something like this we can create. Okay, so here whatever we're going to be have the transition, so that we are created with the given input. So input is here, we have the 15 mm length, here we need to have the 20 mm length, here we have 25 mm length. Okay, so this is the only task we need to perform in this case, in this CAD model, which is a critical. Okay, so making this transition will be critical, and the another part will be whatever we have the length to angle. Okay, so this angle, if there is any variation in angle, that we can check. Even the length, what we're going to be at, that we will check. So now if there is an interviewer, what interviewer will do, he will change the value of this particular sweep. Okay, he will make to the 20, he will make to the 25 to 15 and check how your parametric model is going to be work over there. Okay, it should be easily get updated. There should not be any error to update. So this is how your model will be get checked. So be make sure whatever you're going to be created, it is not for yourself you are creating. If anyone going to be modify that, so it will be modified easily. Okay, so that means you need to create. So we need to join this all the surfaces now over here. With respect to that, we'll get this flange. Okay, so this flange is get created in this particular area. So now this is how we're going to be modify the class surface. You can trim this too. Okay, from here you can find this to this. We need to trim. And with respect to that, we're going to be get this as a class surface. So whatever the flange we require, so that we can add this flange fillet. So here we're going to be have something like this 3mm flange we require. So we can add that 3mm flange. So here you can check for this particular fillet 3mm we can apply. So this is how we're going to be get this particular 3mm fillet. Okay. Then again, there is another section we have in this condition. Okay. So this is how you can find, you can create the class surface with the master section, whatever is given, as well as you can check the flange we need to create with the angle variation as well as length variation. Okay. So this is the difficulty level you can find somewhere in the CAD test to create for 45 minutes to the 1.5 hour. Okay. So this is a CAD test you can find into the interview.